So let's talk about multiple sclerosis. If in fact, you know, missing certain things causes excess immune response, you'd expect that different cultures might have different rates of multiple sclerosis.
Well, there is a decline for multiple sclerosis, but it's not. It's really that multiple sclerosis tracks affluence and it tracks hygiene. So if you look
at... So cleaner, richer people are more likely to get multiple
sclerosis. Cleaner, richer people are more likely to get multiple sclerosis and type 1 diabetes and various other autoimmune diseases than grubby, poorer people. You know, there's a classic example of that. It's a wonderful natural experiment that was done by a guy called Michael Knipp at the University of Helsinki. And it concerns the state of Karelia, which was broken up after the war.
Where is Karelia?
Well, it was originally owned by Finland. Mm-hmm. But during the war, the boundaries shifted in favor of Russia. And Karelia found itself split in half. So there is now Finnish Karelia and Russian Karelia. Mm-hmm. And the standard of living gradient between Finnish Karelia and Russian Karelia is the steepest in the world. It's far steeper, for instance, than the gradient between Mexico and here in the US. And there is a vastly greater degree of irritable bowel syndrome, diabetes, and various other autoimmune diseases on the Finnish side. And they've looked at the characteristics of the gut microbiota. Children on the Russian side have a much richer, much more diverse gut microbiota, many more species, and are just a generally healthier
gut. So do we know what makes it? And we have this epidemic of autoimmune disease increasing even in just the last 50 years. Yeah. Do we know what it is we're doing differently that's accounting for this?
Well, I think the two things I would point the gun at would be our rampant overuse of antibiotics, which has been appalling and unrestrained, as you know, for decades now, and our obsessive interest in hygiene. I mean, it's obviously you can't have it both ways. We've made huge strides in the world in terms of cleaning up our environment with regard to diseases, microorganisms, mm-hmm. things like that, proper footwear, better pavements, sanitation of the water supply, better food processing. All these things, of course, have stopped a vast amount of infection with both bacteria and a whole variety of parasitic worms that would normally have infected us. So we've cleaned ourselves up a huge amount. Mm-hmm. But this also continues on a domestic front. I mean, we do tend to be obsessive about hygiene. And the detergent industry feeds our obsession quite merrily with all its products that kill 99.9% of household germs and so forth.
So in the United States, many health and beauty products and soaps have a substance called triclosan, which kills lots of bugs. But apparently in Europe, it's mostly been banned. Is that relevant?
I don't know whether that's relevant. We have plenty of products over in Europe that do the same thing.
Is that right?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And, if you look at the adverts, you will see that one of the main claims they make is that they will destroy practically everything in your home.